Well, the countdown to 2012 is well and truly on, with preparations for tomorrow night's celebrations in Sydney hitting top gear. More than a million people are expected to pack into the CBD to usher in the new year.
It's the showstopper to start the new year. Today, preparations were in full swing and warm-ups underway. Thousands will count down at Sydney's Resolution concert, where Jamiroquai will bring in the new year.
Good. I mean, the really important feeling is that they're freezing their arse off in England.
Police have been preparing for months.
We are not the party police. We are not out to prevent anyone from enjoying themselves and having a drink on New Year's Eve.
Nearly 3,000 officers will patrol party precincts across Sydney. This year, many are alcohol-free.
Our experience has shown that alcohol is probably the biggest problem we have on New Year's Eve.
Good news for pubs and restaurants.
If people do want to drink on New Year's Eve, they've got to come to a licensed venue.
More than a million people are expected to crowd Sydney's waterfronts tomorrow night, and police are hoping for a repeat of last year with less than 100 arrests across the entire city.
Paramedics too are pleading for public help.
We'll be there if you know you need us, but you know it's a bit of common sense on the night to look out for your friends and family.
With so many people crowding into Sydney, the advice is to find a vantage point early. Roads will close from 11 a.m. tomorrow before lanes on the Harbour Bridge shut down after lunch. Tomorrow night, much of the CBD will be shut to traffic and the Anzac Bridge closed for the fireworks.
Plan where you are going to see the fireworks, where you are going to enjoy the occasion, and how you are going to get home.
Andrew Denny, 10 News.